Welcome everyone. Today we shall continue with the chapter on agriculture. Last time we have discussed on the overall nature and the feature and the characteristics of Indian agriculture. Today in detail we will discuss about the two main type of agriculture for which India is actually doing the cultivation. And for that we will be discussing today the cash crops and the food crops, and we shall begin with the food crops.
I said that we will begin with the food crops, but before that let us have an understanding between the difference between the two types of crops, the cash crops and the food crops. Cash crops, obviously these crops which are cultivated or the agriculture is done mainly for earning money, whereas food crops is mainly for eating purpose. These are staple food. So cash crops, the examples are oil seeds like groundnut, mustard, castor, coconut, fibrous, they are cotton, jute, plantation, coffee, rubber, tea, other crops, sugar cane, etc. On the other side, food crops are mainly the cereals. They are rice, wheat, maize, oats, bajra, ragi, etc. Pulses. India is quite well known for different or various kinds of dals. So pulses, gram, moong dal, masoor dal, raher dal, urad dal, etc. Spices. Obviously, India is also known to the whole world for its spices. And some of the examples are cardamom, pepper, and there are many other. Now, before you proceed with this detailed discussion, dear children, just know, follow the syllabus, strictly follow the syllabus. Under each head, suppose I am discussing about rice, okay? So what you have to study about rice? Under these four heads, climatic conditions, soil requirement, methods of cultivation, and obviously the processing or the distribution, the methods of different distribution means which part of India is producing the maximum, etc. We have discussed earlier about the three types of crops that are grown in India: kharif crop, rabi crop, and zaid crop. Rice is a kharif crop, that means it is a summer crop. Rice is the most important staple crop of India. The majority of Indians live on this crop. It grows almost everywhere in India. Obviously, some places it grows very well, in some places comparatively with a less yield capacity. Our country is the second largest producer of rice in the whole world after China. What are the climatic or conditions that are required for rice cultivation? It needs a temperature between 22 to 32 degrees Celsius with very high humidity. Rainfall should be between 150 to 300 centimeter, because the paddy field or the rice field needs stagnant water. Soil is deep clayey or loamy soil. But remember, alluvial soil is the best soil for rice cultivation. The top rice producing states of India: West Bengal, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, and Bihar. rice is the staple food crop of the majority of Indian people. I repeat once again, and India is the second largest producer of rice in the world after China. And states like Assam, West Bengal, and Odisha, there are three crops of the same rice. Means rice can be cultivated three times in a year. The first one is the aus, that is the summer crop, that means from June to October. Then called aman, which can start from October or say November to the end of March. And then finally, there are 2 months left, April, May. There we can have the boro. So rice can be cultivated in three different seasons. In India, rice is cultivated under the following methods. So know these methods of rice cultivation that are prevailed or practiced in India. The first one is the very popular and the easy method called the broadcasting methods. What happens in this method? In these methods, seeds are sown broadcast by hand, that means throwing into this call, and they fall into the or fall on the ground. This method is practiced in those areas which are comparatively dry and less fertile and do not have much labor to work in the fields. It is the easiest method and it requires minimum input, by its yields are also minimum. The second method is known as the drilling methods. In this method, plowing of land and sowing of seeds is done by two persons or even more. Nowadays, of course, plowing is done by tractors if it is done in a very large scale. Then this method is mostly confined to peninsular India. The third method, which is very popular in North India, that is called the transplantation method. What happens? In this method, it is practiced in areas of fertile soil, abundant rainfall, and plentiful supply of labor. So these are the requirements: abundant rainfall, fertile soil, and plentiful supply of labor. To begin with, seeds are sown in nursery and seedlings are prepared. After 4 to 5 weeks, when the seedlings are big, then they are uprooted and planted in the field which has already been prepared for the purpose. The entire process is done by hand. It is therefore a very difficult method and requires heavy inputs, but at the same time it gives some of the highest yield. Now the pick that you are seeing here, this picture, this is actually the method we are discussing here, transplantation. That means you see the buns are here. These buns were taken from the nursery. They were first grown in the nursery initially, and from the nursery they are uprooted and now they are transplanted again. The fourth method is known as the Japanese method. In this method, the use of high yielding varieties of seeds, sowing seeds in raised nursery bed and transplanting the seeds in rows so as to make weeding and fertilizing easy. Weeding means these are our weeds. These are all useless small shrubs, paudha you can call them. So they are uprooted, which actually finishes the fertility of the soil. So they are removed. That process of removing the weeds is known as weeding. And as you know, for the better yield, lots of nowadays the chemical fertilizer like DAP, urea, etc. These are all used. It also involves the use of heavy dose of fertilizer so that very high yields are obtained. The Japanese method of rice cultivation has been successfully adopted in the main rice producing regions of India. The next important food crop of India is wheat. Wheat is a widely adaptable crop that can be grown in climates ranging from temperature to tropical and cold northern parts. Places with a cool, moist weather for most part of the year, followed by a short, dry and warm spell, is most suitable for wheat cultivation. It is necessarily is known as a rabi crop or the winter season crop. The timing is from October, November to March, April. Since the conditions during that time are conducive for growth and ensures maximum yield. You can see this is the green wheat plants. Now the other conditions that are required for the wheat cultivation. I told you, follow the syllabus strictly. So climatic conditions first, temperature, rainfall, soil condition, and the if there are some different methods that is used. Temperature could be between 10 to 15 degrees Celsius during the sowing time and 21 to 26 degrees Celsius during the ripening or harvesting time. Of course, there should be bright sunlight to dry up the crops. Around 50 to 100 centimeter rainfall is required. Soil, it be well drained, fertile or loamy, clammy soil, because unlike rice, wheat cannot grow in the stagnant water. In fact, stagnant water damages the plants. So in India, the Ganga Satluj plains, in roughly we say the northern plains, and the black soil in the Deccan Plateau are the best places for India to grow wheat. Top wheat producing states: Uttar Pradesh, Punjab, Bihar, Haryana and Rajasthan. These are the five states, they say. These are the five top wheat producing states of India. Once again, like the rice, India is the second largest producer after China. This is the second most important cereal also in India. The main food crop in north and northwestern India. Wheat is very much consumed in the northern India. It is mostly consumed in northern India, whereas rice is very much consumed in the southern India. You have heard about perhaps the Green Revolution. We have already discussed about it. The success of Green Revolution contributed to the growth of rabi crops, especially wheat. And Punjab has been very, very, very successful by introducing this Green Revolution method. The third type of food crops in India, together known as millets. So millet is, unlike rice or paddy, is not one particular crop. It is a combination, rather the many crops together are known as millets. It is mainly jowar, bajra and ragi. So these three together are the important millets grown in India. These are known as coarse grains, they have very high nutritional value. The term millets refers to various minor grains. They serve as food grains for the poorer sections of society, and the stalks are used, the stalks of after thrashing the grains from the main plant, what is left out is called stalks, bichali. The stalks are used as fodder crops too. Fodder. It is a food for animals called fodder. They are also known as dry crops because comparatively in the dry region they can grow. Remember, millets are grown in those areas where rice and wheat cannot grow well or cannot grow. So that's why millets are grown there, because if land is fertile and there is a conducive environment and conditions are supplied, obviously the first or second preference will be either rice or wheat, or wheat or rice. But when there is rice and wheat cannot grow, in that kind of places the millets are grown. The basic requirements for the millets to grow. The temperature may range from 27 degree to 32 degree Celsius. However, it shouldn't be below 16 degree Celsius. Rainfall should be comparatively less rainfall, you understand. That is 50 to 120 centimeter. However, the average rainfall should be within 100 centimeter. Soil, point to be noted, normally grown in less fertile soils, because in fertile soils, rice and wheat are grown. So normally grown in the less fertile soils, as much as such soils are used for rice, wheat, or major staple food crops. So they can grow in light and heavy alluvial soil, red soil, or even sandy soil. Now, rice is a kharif crop, wheat is a rabi crop, whereas millets, there are varieties of what is called crops, no? They can be cultivated both as rabi as well as kharif crops. The growing period is about 4 to 5 months. Methods, both the broadcasting and dibbling methods are used. We have already discussed while we are talking about rice methods cultivation. Now, regions, a vast area of India is having the millets, because India has got lots of land which is very hilly, plateau regions, etc., etc. So due to which, where rice and wheat cannot be grown, so the major parts are mainly the Deccan Plateau and Gujarat. Now, Jowar and Bajra are cultivated in Uttar Pradesh. Remember, these are the names we are giving in now in detail. Particularly, Jowar and Bajra cultivated in Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, etc. And Ragi is grown in Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, and Telangana. Dear children, by and large, we have to accept that India is still a poor country. So, hamare desh mein dal roti abhi bhi chalu hai. So, roti comes from wheat, but the dal comes from pulses. And India grows a good amount of pulses, varieties of pulses, and many of you are quite aware of them. I have given just three names here, three examples, but there are plenty of examples of dals, and perhaps you are also eating some of them. India is the largest producer as well as the consumer of pulses in the world. Good point. There are major sources of protein. These pulses are major sources of, we call the vegetable protein in the vegetarian diet. Being leguminous, you know your biology, because they got nitrogen fixing bulbs. So being leguminous crops, most of these crops help in restoring the soil fertility by mixing nitrogen from the air. So these are natural fertilizer. Actually not fertilizer, natural. It's called naturally they fix the nitrogen. So that's why in some places after the rice or wheat or major crops, they just leave 1 year, or in between they also grow these kind of crops in order to get the nitrogen back to the soil. Therefore, these are mostly grown in rotation with other crops. Major pulses that are grown in India are arhar dal, urad dal, moong, masoor, peas, matar, or gram, chana. we have some pick for here, the masoor dal. Okay, we can see in a bigger way. This is masoor dal, and this is urad dal, and this is the moong dal. If you have not seen them, please don't go to the market now. Okay, if you have got in your kitchen, you can ask your whoever is in the kitchen in charge to show you. If you are not aware whichever dal that you are eating, just have a look of it. Now the conditions required for the this type of dals. More or less, in general, the temperature ranges from 20 to 25 degrees Celsius, but a mild, cool and dry climate is most favorable. Pulses are grown both as ravi in the northern India, and as well as kharif in the southern India, south, okay, kharif crops and ravi crops. Rainfall ranges from 50 to 100 centimeter. Excessive rainfall during sowing or harvesting, absolutely harmful. Excessive rainfall is not required. Soil should be dry, light soil, which is enough for pulses to grow. Once again, remember, pulses is not the main staple food. In India, rice and wheat are always given the first preference. Harvesting. The growing period is about 150 days, is almost like 5 months. When they are dry, plants are uprooted, kept for drying up, and then thrashed to separate the grains from the plants. And most of the cases, whatever is left out after the grains collection, then the stalks or the part of the plants are also used as fodder, or sometimes they are also been used for fuel in the means cooking purpose. Regions in which part of India they grow well. The great plains of the northern India, that means Ganga Satluj region, is the ideal regions for the pulses to grow. However, Punjab, you know very well, Sarso ka saag and chara saag is very famous in Punjab. So Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh and Bihar are the main pulses growing states of India. So dear children, if you go through your book, you will find out that this particular content or lesson that we have discussed here has been given as a chapter, okay? But in ICAC, agriculture is taken as a whole complete topic. So agriculture in general, then the crops, cash crop and food crops, and the next chapter will be discussing about the agro-based industries, that is on, okay? Now I hope this has helped you if you go through this. And study well, stay well, stay safe, and stay well until we meet again when the school reopens.